Thank you.
This is a segment called Holy Cannoli. And for some reason, Billy Jeff has a halo.
Because we know that is not the truth. That's a little odd, but I mean, it covers my, gives me a little more hair, maybe. I don't know.
I don't know what the halo's about, but I am digging the name of this segment. So.
And if people don't remember, we'd like to have our cannolis, right?
Yes,
we like to bring
like
in for you. And I'm sorry that I haven't brought some Mike's Pastry in for you. The best in the world. I will bring you a box next time I'm here.
Good. You should be sorry. Let's get right to the good stuff.
All right.
I'm going to give you a topic, and you're going to tell me how many cannolis.
Oh, or what type of cannoli, too?
Sure.
Okay.
It's your segment, pal.
Oh.
You do whatever you want.
Here we go.
First up, holy cannoli, the Islanders are in first place.
This is a big box of cannolis. I mean, I'm going to give one cannoli each to Lou Lamoriello. I'm going to give one to Barry Trotz. Let's not forget Mitch Korn, who he brought in, who's really done a great job of filling the cannoli, so to speak, because his goaltenders have been great. And how about Josh Bailey and Matt Barzal? Anders Lee, I'd give Anders Lee his own box too for taking on the role of captaincy right there. So as far as, look, there's jumbo cannoli, there's full-size cannolis, there's the mini cannolis. These guys aren't getting the mini. The minis are the kind you get at the wedding that sit out for too long and you're like, this is soft, it's not good. I'm giving these guys fresh cannolis, filled right there. Maybe some, you know, pistachio filling, definitely some maple, but regular ricotta for sure with chocolate chips on the outside. They deserve a full box of cannolis so far. You just don't want the cannolis to go stale. So eat them up, guys. Do not get lazy. They've been great so far.
They really have, and they're getting some grade A cannolis for their efforts,
they are,
according to Mr. Jaffe. Next up, the Penguins have lost four in a row and have been outscored 10-1 in their last two games.
Yeah, no, their box is empty. I was going to maybe give them, I wanted to give them three. No, I'm down to two, maybe one big regular full-size cannoli dipped in chocolate on the sides, because they are the Penguins after all, and they do have some cred, the street cred, having won so much the last couple of years, but they're just not playing well right now. Their defense at times has been very porous, very stale, and they haven't deserved a big thing of cannolis. And
are they getting stale cannolis then?
No, I'm not going to give them stale just yet. It's early on in the season, and I don't want to do that to the Penguins because Mirzi's there, and Mirzi could go and eat a whole box of cannolis on his own. So even though I gave them a box of cannolis, a box of Mike's, Mirzi would probably steal them all and probably finish them all between the bus ride from the rink to the airport. He's that big of a food chow
hound. I've heard this about him. Apparently, dude can eat.
Oh, my God, it's the bottomless pit. It is. It absolutely is. I mean, Mirzi, the per diem doesn't even last him through breakfast, I don't think, he eats so much.
All right, well, holy cannoli, the Rangers have won four games in a row.
Yeah, and I'm giving David Quinn and David Oliver, Lindy Ruff, Greg Brown, the new coaching staff there, I'm giving them each a nice cannoli. I am. They've earned it. It hasn't been always pretty, all right? It really hasn't. But the only reason, not the only, but a big reason that they've gotten better the last few games, Jackie, is Henrik Lundqvist. He might get his own cannoli store when it's all said and done. The issue is this.
Well,
let's not confuse them. Lobster tail is different. It's different pastry. It's got three different creams in it. The cannoli's different. Cannoli's is cannoli filling. Jack, don't go somewhere, Jackie, that you know not to. You do not know where
you are. The expert. I apologize.
You're very welcome.
I'm not a cannoli expert.
It's okay. We all have our specialties in life. But there's a difference between the New York cannoli and the Boston cannoli.
Right.
I still think Henrik Lundqvist, who is the king. I don't know if he's not the king of cannolis, but he deserves his own. He's been, the last couple, he's bought in. He's really bought in there. He's buying what David Quinn and his coaching staff is preaching. And I think that says an awful lot right there. The other guys are picking it up. We know about Pionkskol. That was worthy of a nice cannoli last night, too. But let's give them four. Let's give them four big ones.
All right, four big cannolis. Elsewhere, the Coyotes. Holy cannoli. They have the best penalty kill in the league at 90.2%, and they have seven shorties.
So let's give them seven cannolis. Let's give it
Love
to them.
It.
The problem with giving something like that to the desert is they will go stale a little bit sooner. So don't put the filling in the shell just yet. We're going to send them a care package. The filling's going to be on the side. They're going to fill, every time they go shorthanded, they're going to fill up another cannoli because they're going to get another shorthanded goal. I think they're going to have like 69 shorthanded goals this season. That's the rate that they're going on right now. So that's what they're
sounds
earning.
That's sustainable.
I think it's very sustainable. It absolutely is. I think that these guys, it's a lot of fun where they're at right now with their penalty kill. They're making life miserable for the opposition. This would be the team's best penalty kill ever since coming to the Phoenix area. Go back to 98, 99. 99 when they're in the high 80s. So I give Rick Tocchet and his staff a lot of credit and a lot of cannolis, a lot of good cannolis for this one. I would even give them, I'm getting into this team a little more. I'd give them a few other side pastries for Mike Stew for this
one.
Oh,
wow, a few.
I would, because, you know, I want them to do well. They've teased us an awful lot. Let's sugar high them up a bit and give them a few more things.
All right, well, we can't have Billy Jaffe talking cannolis without adding a little Boston flavor.
Oh,
so how about this? Holy cannoli, Jaro Halak leads the NHL with a 952 save percentage. You did not hear me incorrectly. 952.
A Halak of cannolis. Jaro Halak is going to get a Halak
of them. A Halak of cannolis.
He is. He's
a not, Halak of cannolis.
He's not familiar with, too familiar with Boston that much yet. You know, he's got new there this year. What a signing by Don Sweeney, bringing him in. He has really helped stabilize this team and allowing Tuukka Rask, who hasn't found his game nearly as much, Jackie, to get into that rhythm, and they're hoping that he can. But Halak has earned. He's earned a future. I guarantee he's going to get some personalized trips to Mike's Pastries this year to pick up whatever kind of cannoli he wants. I'm a big Florentine shell cannoli fan. The regular cannoli shell is the one that's, you know what it is. You fry that one up. That's not bad. But the Florentine one is a baked one. It's more of a cookie. It's unbelievable. I'm telling you, I will bring you one. You have to have it.
You're making me hungry. I'm already mad at you because you didn't bring me any cannolis like you used to last year. It's like now that I'm not a rookie anymore, I don't get cannolis.
No, you will. Don't you worry. It has timing is everything. Let's just get into listen, we had to get going again this season. Only been here 4 or 5 days so far. I'll be back soon enough. We'll bring you some cannolis. Special delivery.
All right. Well, I've been doing all the holy cannoli. So as we take this to break, can you give me a holy cannoli?
Holy cannoli.